listening to MySweetFM.com. You're locked in to MySweetFM.com.
You're listening to MySweetFM.com.
Are you tired of toil?
Listen to my program, Ancient of Days Outreach Bible Ministry, by Deaconess Juliette Amos at MySweetFM.com every Tuesday from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. To listen live in the U.S., call 605-475-5848. In the U.K., call 0330-3326-335 or at 97.5 FM that you can download on iTunes. Just search for MySweetFM. To speak to me live, call 020-351-97611 and 07-555-988-739. To text me, it's 6077. You love Jesus, you love God.
Kafari, greeting to you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Today is another Tuesday. I welcome you all in Jesus' name. You are all blessed. The blessing of God shall not depart from us in Jesus' name. And this is my program, Prophet Juliette Amos, on my Ancient of Days Bible Ministry. Right now, I am in Radio 97.5 FM on MySweetFM.com, the best station in the world. Right now, you can listen live and watch live at YouTube right now by type Prophet Juliette Amos on MySweetFM.com. And you can listen live to go to www.mysweetfm.com to listen live by calling USA number 6054755843. To listen live by calling UK number 0330332635. No extra call on mobiles. And if you want to call live to speak to me live, you can call 020-3519-7611 or mobile number 07-55-59-88-739, and you can text the same number 07-55-59-88-739. Thank you. God bless you all. I greet you again in Jesus' name. I bless you in the name of Jesus. I hope right now you have called family, friends, and sit down to listen to the word of God that comes to you every Tuesday. And I believe you have been blessed with the word of God that has been coming to you every Tuesday. And I hope you watch every day and call friends to watch the same on YouTube live. Thank you all in Jesus' name. And today, once again, we continue where we ended last week, which is, where is your heart desire? You know, last week we talked about, where do you desire? Where is your heart? What do you think about your heart? What did you do with Jesus Christ, with God? Do you put your heart into the things of God, or do you let your heart be of the things of this world? Because the Bible has given us a warning that we should not let our mind, our heart, our desire to be things of this world, that our desire should be things of the Lord, that we should be thinking of heaven. Not that you want to die or you are going to be living in heaven, you will be in this life. But what the Bible was saying and what the Lord was saying, as a child of God, and as you accept God as your personal Savior, and that your mind should every time be to Him, thinking of Him, thinking of what you can do, you should forget about the things of this world. He said the things of this world will pass away because they are just a minor things. Though your Father provide many these things in the world for you so that you can live on it, but He don't want you to set your mind, your affection on it. He don't want you to put your mind that, I want to have money. I want to buy. He doesn't want you to be pursuing things of this world. He said, if you pursue the God, your God, the word of God, if you look for it, He said, all these things I will give unto you. I think last week, I give you an example that when the Lord called Solomon, He asked, what do you want me to do for you? And Solomon said, if you can give me a wisdom, a knowledge to deal with these people, They are not my children. I cannot control them without your knowledge, without your wisdom. And God said, because you did not ask for their life, you did not say, Father, give me sword to kill these people. You did not say, Father, oh, it is time for me to destroy these people that have fought against my father. He said, because of that, I give you everything, that I bless you, and no one shall be blessed like you again in the world. This is what the Lord was saying. Set your affection, set your mind, let your thinking, let your heart desire to be unto God of things in the heaven, not on things on this world. Don't pursue things of this world. Don't run after things of this world. This is what the Lord is saying. He's telling you that you are my child. It's like a baby. He wants you to, you know, when you have a baby, a baby don't know anything. All baby need is that he wants to see his mother, expecting from his mother what the mother will give to him. Every time he cried to his mother, he wants the mother to carry him. He wants the mother to give him the same what he has been doing, feeding him with food, carry him, play with him. That is what the Lord was saying, that you are my child. I want to carry you like a baby. So don't look there and there. Don't look others. Don't look outside. He said, be with me. Come to me, come closer. Let your heart be unto me like the baby look unto their mother. You know, baby don't know anything. All they know is just their mother. And they look at the mother's eyes every time. Every time they see the mother, they jump up. And every time they jump and they look at the mother know their expectation. This is what the Lord was saying. I know your expectation. I know what you need. I create all these things for your need, and I know you need them. You need money in life. You need clothes in life. You need house in life. You need cars in life. And he said, but don't set your mind in. So don't pursue all these things. Don't run after all these things. I want you to run after seeing me, looking for me, believing in me, that all these things I will give unto you. If you set your mind towards me, if you give me time, if you give chance, if you give heart of the 24 hours, if you let God use 12 of it, and the remaining 12 will be for you. But most of us, we use the whole 24 hours to be running after things of this world. And at the end of it, most of it, we did not achieve it. But if we set our affection on God, our mind, our desire, we will achieve everything. We will have enough. And it will not be in a sorrow. It will not even in a thing that we have to struggle. It will not be like the Israelite journey. You can see that where Israel was going is not too far, it's nearby. Just because they did not put their affection, their mind with God, God knows them. He let them walk the journey of a day for 40 years. This is what the Lord is saying. He doesn't want you to use a journey of a day for 40 years. He doesn't want you to run after the thing that you will pursue for 10 years, 20 years. You are still on it. You want to be down. You are still planning. You are still running for it. You are still to collect money, gather money, and you are not able. But this thing is so easy. It's something that your Lord can do, because all things are possible. When you don't even expect, it can make a way where there's no way. It can open door where you think where others' door were shut. It will make things possible for you when people are running after they are looking, they ask you, how do you do it? And you say, I don't even know how I do it. I don't even know how I make it. It is just God. This is what the Lord was saying. I'm your father. Come on to me. Everything belongs to me. Say, gold and silver belongs to me. Everything belongs to me. Blessing belongs to me. Protection belongs to me. You can see what is happening in the world. It is only those people that have the mark of Christ, that God has put their mark on him, that God has said that as you go now, I'm with you, my daughter, as you come in, I'm with you. If not, those people that they fall on that, we did not laugh at them. It is not because we were now mocking them, but we were just saying it. There's no other way for you to live. There's no other way for you to enjoy this world according to the word of the Lord. The only way is the Calvary, is the cross, is Jesus Christ. He said, carry your cross and follow me. This is the only way. He said, I stand at the door, I'm knocking. If you open, I will come in. He said, because I'm your creator, why should I leave you to suffer? He said, I did not create you to come and suffer. He said, but you will call on me, I will answer you. You will ask anything in my name, and the Lord will do it. He said, everything you ask in my name, the Lord is going to do it, because he has sent me. I have suffered to bring you back to him, to deliver you from the hands of evil enemy. Then why now are you not in the house? Why are you outside in? Let us look at this, the ten women that welcomed Jesus. They say the five, they are so wise. They have the oil in their lamp. But remember, the five of them, they call them foolish. Foolish. Because they did not have the oil, they are not prepared. Their mind, their desire is not of God. They think of this world, and they were carried away by these things of the world. Unfortunately for them, they cannot ride with Christ. They cannot go in with Christ when Christ comes. But look at the five wise women. They have it. They prepare. They set their affection. They are ready. And when the Lord comes, and they go in with Christ, and they die with Christ, and everything perfect for them. But the other one, God say, I didn't know you when they come back. They knock at the door. He say, who are you? Go away. I don't know you. May you not be our own in Jesus' name. So today, the children of the law, I am calling you and I'm telling you, we know every Tuesday is based on teaching of God, how we should walk with God, how we should perfect our life, how we should move, how can we be perfect in our repentance. If you repent, you say you become a new creation. To repent is not enough. You can be repent and you're not perfect in it. How can you be perfect in your repentance? When you say, Lord, you repent, here I am, I give my life, I become a born again, and you did not let your affection and you did not let your desire to be the things of God, and then how can you be perfect in what you are doing? You can only be perfect when you commit your total soul, yourself, commit yourself, everything in you, into the God, into the hands of God. When you soak yourself into the law, into the word, when you are rooted into it, into the word of God, he say rooted yourself. When you rooted yourself into the word of God, into the Bible, into the Jesus, and you talk to him daily and he speak to you every day, you will see the joy in coming to Christ. This is why I'm telling you that children of the law, it is good to give your affection, to give your heart. It is good to know the God you are serving. It is good to walk with him. It is good to let people know that he is your God. It is good to let your desire to be unto God. He does not say you are not going to be blessed. He does not say you are not going to marry or you are not going to eat. He does not say you should not marry. You are going to marry. People will see you. You as a child of God, he did not say you are not going to wear. You're supposed to put on the best clothes. You see, you're supposed to have the best car, because all these things, he know you need it, because he don't want you to be looking at the other, so he will provide it for you. But he's calling you. He's called you today. He said, come, I have everything. Let's go to Romans chapter 8. We read part of it last week. We need to continue from there. Romans chapter 8, let's start from verse 4. He said, that the righteous of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. He said you should not walk after the flesh, but after the spirit. That is, what are the spirit? He said the fruit of God, of things of God, which is not of this world. The spirit is God. Jesus is spirit. The Lord is spirit. Holy Spirit is spirit. He said the flesh is you. It's not just the body. The flesh is you. That is, when you commit yourself into things of this world, when you commit yourself into affection, your desire into this of this world, that is, you are in flesh. But if you let your desire to be of the Lord, when you commit, when you are come out of the flesh, when you pray, when you deliver yourself from the flesh, no one can deliver you from your flesh. Because if the preacher preach every day for 100 years, and if you don't come out of the shell, which is yourself, your flesh, no one, even Jesus, cannot get you out. Because if God say don't do this and you do it, it is impossible for him to deliver you. The only way he can deliver you, set you free, bless you, give his glory, let it shine upon you, is for you to come out of your flesh and have your desire and your living and your stay and your eating and partake in his table, to dine with him. This is what the Bible was saying. Verse 5 said, for they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the spirit, the things of the spirit. That is, if you, like I was saying now, if you're after the flesh, everything is going to be that your mind, your affection is just to be of the world, thinking, or everything in you will be of this world. But if you set your affection on the spirit of God, and you let that one dominate the flesh, if the spirit of God dominate the flesh in you, you will enjoy what your Lord has for you. This is what the Bible was saying. It said, for to be carnally minded is dead, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. That is, you will have peace and life. Your family, your children, your household, there will be peace and everything, because it's your God. It will guide you. It will protect you. You will be in the shadow of the law, and no evil will fall upon you. And no enemy, he said, if they fight against you, I will fight against them. And he said, the battle is not yours, and he will stand by you. And whoever rise against you, you don't need to fight. It's just for you. Look at Joseph and the children of the Judah. When Joseph received the letter, nothing did he do than to take the letter to God, because he know that he has set himself on the spirit. He has soaked himself. He have God. He doesn't have other. We say, Father, look at this letter that I received from my enemy. And the Lord said, you don't have to do anything. Yours is just to go there singing, dancing, rejoice, leave everything for me. And the God fight the battle. He destroyed the enemy. But this thing cannot work if you have the flesh. You are not going to be able. It will be difficult for you to go and say, God, deliver me. And even if you go, your mind will tell you. You will know, because we all have conscience, that am I doing the work of God? Am I doing things of God? Did I obey God? Did I come to him? Why should it be that just in time of problem? You see? So these are the things. But when God, just go out and be rejoiced. And he go out, he tell them, say, rejoice. And the Lord send his prophet, say, don't worry. The battle is not yours. And he fought the battle for them, and he destroyed the enemy. You see? This is what the Lord was saying. He said, so because the carnal mind is empty against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can live. You see, he said the flesh, it will not submit. He said it can't. This is why I say, you can only kill the flesh. You can only come out of the shell, which is your flesh, if it's you, because the flesh don't want to. People say the spirit willing, but the flesh don't want. Who are the flesh? What is, it is you. If you willing, you willing to. It is what you willing to do. Nobody can force you to do anything. You see, if you don't want to do it, you don't want to do it. If you want to do it, you want to do it. If you want to come out of it, it's you. If they preach and you listen to preacher every day, if you don't want to see, you say, what are they saying? They are saying nonsense. Who is Christ? Who is God? I believe it's enough. I go to church, it's enough. I pray, it's enough. No, that's not what God said. He did not ask you to pray. Children of the Lord, right now, I'm in Radio 97.5 FM Radio, mysweetfm.com. mysweetfm.com. Children of the Lord, if you want to watch live right now, you can go to YouTube and watch live, or you watch later. You call friend, call family, show it to friend, let people watch it, because it is the word of God that comes to you. So children of the, you can watch on you can download, tune in and search for my WWFM and watch it live or watch later. Right now, if you want to listen live, by calling USA number, you can call 0-54-755-5843. To listen live by calling UK number 0-33-0-33-26-335. No extra call on mobiles. And you can call live now on 020-3519-7611, or to call live on mobile number 0-75-55-988-739. Children of the Lord, This is where the word of God comes to you every day. So, children of the Lord, as I was saying to you, that the Lord is good all the time. There's nothing our God cannot do. You see, children of the Lord, it is good to know the God you are serving. It is good to give your heart. It is good to let God do things for you, not you. Don't need to suffer, my children of the Lord. You don't need to suffer. You don't need to be walking. You don't need to struggle. You don't need devil to disturb your life, to be deceiving you. This is why you need to give your heart to the Lord your God, to God your Father. You see? Let us go to Romans 5 from verse 6. Let us go to Romans 5 verse 6. The reason why you have to, the reason is, for when we were yet without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. You see the reason. You see why you have to believe and know that this is the real God. This is the person you need to give your life to. Because where you are yet, and the Lord, he said, he died for you when you are yet ungodly. You see? This is the reason. For a righteous man we won't die, yet peradventure for a good man some would dare to die. You see, but God commanded his love toward us in that while we were yet sinner, Christ died for us. You see, it even when we were yet sinner, he has died for us. This is why you should believe in him and have your heart to be unto him, and you should let him to take everything, take every of your problem, take your heart, provide for you, deliver you, save you. So, children of the Lord, he said, for scarcely for a righteous man. He said, but God commanded his love toward us. You see, God so loved us that he gave us Jesus Christ. Because he know what devil can do. He know what is going to be happening on this world. This is why he has given us Jesus Christ to come and deliver. And he surrendered himself. You see? Oh, if you really know him or you love him, you will really, so you yourself, he did not ask you to give your life to die. But he's asking you to give your life to save, to enjoy. He said, much more than being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. He said, you can only be saved through him. From the wrath of anything that you may be going through, you can only be saved through him. This is the reason why you need to give your heart. You should let your desire be upon him. Because for without him, there's no way. For if when we were enemy, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son. You see, by his death, we were reconciled to our Lord, our God. Much more, being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. We can only be saved. Things are going on. Life is full of ogs. Life is full of Satan. He knows. That is why he sent Christ. And this is why you should be with him. This is why you should not go away. You should not be far to him. You can only be saved through him. And not only so, but we also joy in God through our Lord Jesus. You can only have your joy through our Lord Jesus Christ. From God, anything you want God to do for you, it is through his blood that he has shed, through his love that he has given, show unto us. Because he surrendered himself. He loved you. He loved me. He gave his life. Why then? What is he demanding for you? He did not ask you to come and die on the cross. He did not say, come and die the way I die. He did not say, he was even telling you, don't die the way I die, so that enemy will not just, you know. So this is why God is saying, Jesus said, the Bible, the word said, your desire, commit yourself to me. Surrender yourself. Come unto me, all ye that labor. Why should you labor? He said, call on me and I will show myself to you. I will let you be with me. You will die. You will be on the table with me. You will reason with me. Even when you are dead, You will not die. You will still be with me, because my blood my I've shed for you will be upon you. This is the reason, children of the law. For, you see, and not only so, but we also joy in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have now received the atonement. You see? Through him, children of the law, through him, without him, there's nothing we can do. There's no other way. Every other way is a lie, is a counterfeit. Every other way is a counterfeit. The only way, the only truth. Let us see Psalm, the book of Psalm, chapter 10, verse 3. What did he say? He said, for the wicked boasted of his heart desire, and blessed the covetous, whom the law abnor. You see? The only joy in their own heart desire, the wicked ones. Because they are wicked, they boast. Because they don't have Christ. They don't believe in God. And their way, they go in wrong way. Their way goes that way. And there's no way they can change. This is why he said the heart cannot subject. They cannot come down. You see? Children of the law, why are you there suffering? Why are you there without coming? Why are you? Why? You've known him. He have manifest himself. He have shown himself to you. What do you think you need to do? What do you think you're supposed to do? Why don't you come right now? Do not be late. Give your desire to him. You see? Give your desire to him. Let us see the book of Colossians chapter 3 and see what he said. He said, verse 2, he said, set your affection on things above, not on things on this earth. You see, what are the things above? That is things of God, the command of God, the love of God, everything that is spiritual, everything that is not of this world, everything that is not anything that is above, is not of the flesh, is not of the fruit of the spirit. The fruit of the spirit. What are the fruit of the spirit? That is your love to God, to neighbors, to everyone around you. You see? To do things, let people see see God in you, to walk faithfully, to come in, to serve, to know God, to go out and evangelize to others, to bring people to the house. There are many mansions, to bring people, to commit people, to help people, to deliver people, to deliver people. You see? So, children of the Lord, you need to come right now. Submit. Let your desire be. He said, modify therefore your member which are upon the earth. He said, you see, your heart, everything. Children of the law, it is good to have Christ in you. If you have Christ in you, your life, you yourself, you will see the difference. You will know that if Christ lives in you, you yourself. Let us see the book of Galatians 5. Verse 24, and they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with their affection and lust. You see, they crucify their affection and the lust. The affection, that is the affection of this thing, and the lust of all things of this world. You crucify it with the cross. Those you see, they that are Christ, you have to, if you believe, you have to crucify all the laws, the flesh. You have to crucify them, the things of this world. You see, that's what he was saying. Your affection, not you, you have to condemn them. You have to let your affection be of Christ. He so much love you. God so much love you that he gave his begotten son so that you might be saved. He will give you life, give you peace, give you joy, happiness, family, children. What do you need? What do you want? You cannot be barren when you are with God. Barren of anything, of children, of blessing. You cannot be barren. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He will not let enemy have power over you, because it's your God. Children of the law, why are you waiting? Why do you stay far away? Why not now? What are you thinking right now? that you are listening to the word of God. What is in your heart? What is your thought now? What is your mind right now? Let us see the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 31. It says, "But covet earnestly the best gift, and yet show I unto you a more excellent way." The excellent way is the one I'm saying now, talking to you, telling you the excellent way is of the Lord. That is the only excellent way that you can be saved, the only excellent way that you can have life, that you can have peace, is to set your affection. Though you've been listening to the word of God, though you've been reading the Bible, but there's things you did not do. It is you, though you have been going to the church, though you fellowship with members, others, but there's things you are still left behind. It's because you are still in your flesh. That is why you are still doing things of this world. You still fight, you get angry, you still bite, you still destroy people at back. Those are the things of the flesh. This is what the enemy wants. He wants you to be in the house of God and he don't want you to receive. There you gather, you mock in the house of God. You bite, you laugh at people. You see? You say you are born again. You say you repent, but still you are still in the flesh, which means you have not been perfect in your repentance. If your repentance is perfect, you will not do all these things. Children of the law, this is what the Bible is saying for you. To be perfect in him is that there be fruit. People should see the fruit should grow in you. Give your heart. Children of the law, it is good to have Christ. It is good to know God. It is good to walk in way. You see? Let us go to the book of John. Let's see verse 2. What did it say? Verse 2 said, "Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you." Verse 2 says, "Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, I did keep it away, taken away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purge it, and that may bring forth more fruit." Yes, it will bring forth more fruit. Children of the Lord, right now, we want to let us go for a break for a few minutes. We come back just a few minutes, and I want you to remain, keep watching it. And if there's people who have not been able to partake right now, go and call them. I'll come back in a few minutes. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Thank you.
Listen to my program, Ancient of Days Outreach Bible Ministry, by Deaconess Juliet Amos at mysweetfm.com every Tuesday from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. To listen live in the U.S., call 605-475-5848. In the U.K., call 330-336-335 or at 97.5 FM. And you can download our
when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe. Sings my soul, my Savior, God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul. God, his son not sparing, send him.
Bible Ministry by Deaconess Juliette Amos at MySweetFM.com every Tuesday from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. To listen live in the U.S., call 605-475-5848. In the U.K., call 0330-3326-335 or at 97.5 FM that you can download on iTunes. Just search for My Sweet FM. To speak to me live, call 020-351-97611 and 07-555-988-739. To text me, it's 607. You love Jesus, you love God.
Are you tired of toiling, of struggling with?
God bless you, children of the Lord. Thank you all. I hope you are still there, you are watching, and you've called people who have not been present before. God bless you. The blessing of God will not depart from you. Thank you for watching. And right now, I'm still in radio 97.5 FM, mysweetfm.com radio, the best radio. You can watch live right now in YouTube or listen live. You can watch later. You can chat with me on YouTube or chat with me on Google at just type mysweetfm.com and you chat with me, then I will answer you. You can call live right now for prayer or for question at 020-3519-7611 or mobile 075-5598-8739 to listen live by calling USA number 60-5475-5843 to listen live by calling UK number 033-033-26-335. You can watch live right now at YouTube or watch later anytime. You can download TuneIn and search for www.mysweetfm.com and watch live and watch later. Thank you. God bless you. We were in the word of the law that say, where is your heart desire? Hidden of the law, where did you put your heart desire? Where did you put your mind, your thinking, your affection? Is it of the law? Did you have the Christ in you? Are you against Christ? Did you let God walk through you? Did you let cast all your burden upon him? Did you even believe in him? Did you even let him do things for you? Are you so struggle in the world? Why are you so struggle? He said, let us see John 15 verse 4. He said, abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself. You see, he said, you cannot bear fruit of yourself unless you abide in me. Unless you are in me, except it's abide in the vine. No more one can ye. He said, except ye abide in me. Except you abide in me, you cannot bear fruit. You cannot do anything. It is not impossible. Because unless you cast your burden, unless you believe, unless you give your heart, unless you commit, unless you walk with me, unless you surrender your life, unless you give everything to God, the life is full of holes, problems, trouble, affliction. You see, you have to come, you have to let him save you. It is only God, the people that God saved, that can be saved. Even family problem, you see, what you do, especially people from the Africa, can see the polygamous family full of problem. You see, nations against nation. Even family against family, children against mother, mother against children, full of problem. Who can save you? Who can deliver you? Except Christ, except God. And where can you see Christ? In the word of the law, in your mind, in your heart, in your surrender, in your life, in your commitment. You see, children of the law, he said you cannot. Let us read it again. In that John 15 verse 4, he said, abide in me. That is in me, Lord Jesus, in me, Christ, abide in me, Holy Spirit. He said, and I in you, until I live in you, until you abide and I'm in you. I control your life, I control your way, I control everything in you. Then you'll be delivered, you'll be saved, you'll be saved from the world problem. He said, unless I in you, he said, if not, you say, how can you be saved? And the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine. You know that no more can ye except ye abide. Children of the Lord, you have to abide in him. You have to come to him. You have to commit everything. You have to search for him. Search for him. Like you go into the computer, in the internet, the technology of our day, you search for things in the technology. This is what the Lord says, search for me daily, day and night. They did not that day and night come look for the way, the truth way, the only truth way. Without that way, there's no other way. You see, let us see John 16 verse 33. What the word of the Lord say? He say, this thing I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In me you will have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation. Tribulation. You can see a lot of tribulation in the world. The world is full of tribulation. Daily, every day, you read from the news, you watch in the media, in the television, in radio, you listen, you hear people, you see news. News every day. The world is full of tribulation. Earthquake, tsunami, things are coming. Things are people, the gunmen, they go out, they killing people. Except you are in me. That is when you can be saved. What is going on out here is enough for you to run to Christ, to let your mind, to set your mind, to say you don't want to die of devil, of affliction. You see, he say, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. It is the person that overcome the world that can overcome for you in your life. If you go to person who cannot overcome the world, he cannot deliver you. There's nothing that can deliver you except from him who has overcome the world for you. He said, I have overcome the world. I have overcome the world. So come unto me. Come unto me. I will give you rest. I will deliver you. I will save you. I will save you. Let us see the book of Galatians chapter 6. Let's see what happened in verse 14. What the Lord said, but God forbid that I should glory save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world is crucified unto me, and I unto the world. The world should be, you should crucify everything, because to him, in him you will have the life. In him you will have the peace. You see, the verse 3 of it say, the verse say, for if a man think himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceive himself. If you deceive yourself, if you are nothing, but if you are something in Christ and Christ make you to be something, you will be something. Children of the Lord, do you really love Jesus? If you really love him, you will we don't need to shout, pray, or before you will go to him. Because if you love your baby, you will love to keep him with you, and the baby will love to be with you. The affection, the love will always draw you to each other. If you really love Christ, the love will always draw you. The affection will make you to, if you go, you will be thinking, oh, let me go to my love. Let me go to my love. It's like husband and wife. When you first marry, the marriage, you know the love I used to be, my love. So if that love is between you and Christ, you will really say, oh, Christ, I want to be with him. And I've missed it. I miss the world. I miss it. I need to go to him. This is why I say, let's set your affection. Set your heart desire. Set your mind on things of the heaven. On things, not on things of this world. Not on things of this world. Not on things of this world. You know the truth of the world. You all know it. You know the fruit of the world. He tell us what are the fruit of the world. You see, the fruit of the world are the things of this world. Are things of this world. But the fruit of God, the fruit of the Spirit, is of the things of the heaven, which the Lord has said we should not put our affection on it. He said we should not set our affection on them. He said we should set our affection. You see, and let us, and our affection of on the God's things, on the God's thing. John, let us see again John 15 verse 5. John 15:5. What did he say? I am the vine and ye are the branches. He that abide with me and I in him, the same bringeth forth fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. You see, again, another word was telling us, we cannot do anything. We cannot do anything without him. We cannot do anything without him. Let us see John 8:32 said, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. And the truth is that the Lord is the right way, is the way. He is the way. He is the way. There's no other way. If you think there's other way, it's a liar. It's a counterfeit. He cannot set you free. He cannot deliver you. You cannot gain anything. Yeah? Let verse 12 say, then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that follow me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of the life. You, if you follow him, if you will, you will have the light. But without him, there will be darkness. Let us close our eyes and see. If there is darkness, every darkness, you see everywhere will be darkness. But if there's a little light, there will be light. This is what the Lord was saying. In me, there's light. Without me, is full of darkness. Darkness is full of trouble. Full of trouble. Tribulations. One after the others. There's no joy. But with him, you will have peace. With him, you will have joy. With him, you will have life. With him, your children will live happily. Your family will live happily. You yourself, people will see you. And look at, let's see John 14:15 said, if you love me, he said, keep my commandment. What are the commandments? The commandment is what I'm telling you. The commandment is that you have to keep your heart. The heart. Not that don't fornicate. If you fornicate, you are killing yourself. If you, a day is coming, we are coming to that. Fornication is not that. It's a sin, but it's not the greatest sin. Most people think fornication, adultery is a greatest sin. It's not the greatest sin. You are killing yourself. If you die of fornication, if you contact it, it doesn't affect God. That is why fornication is just a warning. So, but this, the other thing that said, my commandment is that let your heart, let it be unto me. Believe in me. Walk in me. Have affection in me. Come unto me. Have your heart on me. Walk through me. Do things through me. This is what the Lord says. Love me as I love you. As the Father loves you. And he sent me. And I die for you. This is what the Lord is saying. He said, love me and I love you. Right now, you can chat with me on YouTube. If you need prayer, you don't want to call, you can chat on YouTube. Then I will answer. You can chat at the same time on Google. And then you can type mysweetfm.com and chat. I will answer you. Children, right now, I am in mysweetfm.com. 97.5 FM radio, the best FM, the best radio station. So, children of the Lord, let us see. Let us continue the word of God. I think the word of God is bless you, because as he come to you every Tuesday, I know myself you are blessed, because I'm being blessed in him. And as you listen, I know you are blessed. Your family is blessed. Your life will be blessed. And every affliction in you, I say, in the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy them. Every power that rises against you, by the blood of Jesus, I destroy them in Jesus' name. And everything that say no way, every flesh in your life that did not want to subject to the word of God, subject to the things of God, to the affection of God, right now, I mean the Spirit of Lord to destroy it. I call you forth out of the flesh in the mighty name of Jesus. I say I call you forth out of flesh right now in the name of Jesus. Be ye safe in Jesus' name. The glory of let it fall upon you. Let the light of God shine in your life. Every darkness in your life, I come against it in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the light of God continue to shine in you now. And I pray right now for you to know the difference, for you to come, for you to submit, to let God walk through you. May the Spirit of God continue to abide with you and direct you and show you the way, so that you will know that Lord is good all the time. Children of the Lord, let us see John 15:13. What did he say? 15:13. He said, greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friend. for a man to lay down his life. If they call you, can you lay down your life? Even a finger of you, if say cut it because of one member of your body, let us take it off. If you have love for your children, it's not easy. No one, it's not easy not to talk of somebody who laid down his life. If you really love him, if you really believe, if you, why did he need to call you? He don't need to pursue you before you will jump and start to follow him. Before you will say, oh, no, oh no, oh no, this is the only man I should know in life. This is the only person I should follow in my life. You don't need any other man. He said, let's see verse 9, say 15, verse 9, John 15, I said, as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love. In his love, he said, continue in my love. I love you as the Father loved me. Because if not for love, why should I give my life? Why should I give my life if not for love? But because of the love, Father said, whom will I send? And I said, send me. He know what will happen in this world. That is why he's looking for whom to surrender his life. I surrender my life because of the love that I have for you. And you should love me back. You should love me back. This is what the Lord was saying. You should love me back. Children of the Lord, we should love God back. Because Jesus is a wonderful God. He's a miracle God. He's a marvelous God. There's nothing you need. Oh my God, when I look at what we are passing through, and I look at what the word of the Lord said, and I see the love the Lord has for us, and I see what he was saying, that come unto me, all ye that labor, I will give you rest. In me you can have life, in me you can have peace, in me you can have joy, in me you can have blessing. Then when I look at it and I see that people don't even look at this thing, think of it in second, I say, oh my God, what kind of a flesh are we having that is disturbing us to know our God, to go to the way? Why are we not submitting? Why are we looking for things of this world that will make us to perish? We shall not perish in the mighty name of Jesus. We will not die in Jesus' name. You see, children of God, children of the Lord, you see what I'm saying? You see what the Bible is saying? Because God so much love you, he sent his only begotten son. Let us see the book of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 22. The book of Ephesians, let us see what he said in verse 2. And had put all things under his feet and gave him to be the head over all things to the church. He's the head of everything. This is why he's head of everything. He is the only way. Nothing on head of Satan, head of demon, head of problem, head of tribulation, head of anything whatsoever that you may be going to torment your life. He is the heir. He is the heir. He is the light of the world. If you follow him, you have light. Without him, you cannot have the light. This is why you have to go to him. This is why you have to believe him. This is why you have to live unto him. Because if he live, you live. Because he wakes up, he live, you are going to live. If he arise, you are going to arise. Suppose he did not conquer, you cannot conquer. Suppose he perish, we will all have been perished. But because he did not perish, because he lives, he will come. Then we are all overcome. We are all overcome. Let us see what the Romans chapter 8 verse 35 was saying. Verse 35 of Romans chapter, he say, whom shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, will you let tribulation separate you? Will you let tribulation take you away? Or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? He say, as it is written, for thy sake will I have thee the day long. We are accursed as sheep for the slaughter. You see, what should separate you, sheep of the Lord? Because your Lord is for you. God has made him a curse to die for us. It is not easy to die on the cross. And when what demanded from us is for the love. And if we don't give back the love, what do you want him to be thinking? Even if you do something to somebody and the person did not say thank you, look at how you feel. You feel that the person is ungrateful. We are so much ungrateful for not think of the cross, surrender, walk with him, love him as he loves us, love him back, walk through his way. Let us embrace him. Let us walk through him. Let us put Satan into shame that, no, this man that gave his life, he opened it. Even when he's alive, he raised up a dead man, dead woman. He raised them up. He opened blind eyes. He delivered lame people. What do we need, children of God? Why then are we still not knowing the right way, the right person, the right whom to follow, whom to believe, whom to walk with? Why are we still not in love with him? Why are we still not embracing him? Why are we still going about? Why are we still commit sin that makes him to forsake us? May God not forsake us in Jesus' name. May we not be forsaken in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us see the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 9. And this I pray, that your love may abound yet more and more in knowledge and in the judgment. I pray today that in the mighty name of Jesus, that your knowledge of thinking, the knowledge may abound in the law for you to know more about him. In children of the law, you see, this is my prayer for you today. And today, I pray in the name of Jesus that everything you are going through that don't make you to know the way of God, that you run hectares and hectares for you not to believe, everything that is causing problem in your life, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I cast them out in Jesus' name. I rebuke every power of darkness in your life, in your house, in your business, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every hands that rise against you, in the mighty name of Jesus, may the sword of God destroy them. The sword of God cut them. Right now, let heaven be open because of you, and descend the sword against all your enemies. Every hand that say no to you, I say I command heaven in the mighty name of Jesus, because he said in the mighty name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. I command heaven to send the sword, that every hand that is against you, against your war, against your business, against your life, against your family, against your children, that the sword of the Lord to destroy them in Jesus' name. The sword of God to destroy them. Right now, I commit you into the hands of God. I call the fire of God to be upon you, in your family, in your house, in the life of your children. Right now, I commit the blood of God, blood of Jesus, that he has shed on the Calvary, to come and save you, deliver you. I soak you, soak your household, soak your children, your family into the blood of Jesus. I say right now, I say, go out there and be ye prosper in Jesus' name. I command the mercy of God to be upon you. The Bible said, I will set a table before you, and you will be blessed in the presence of your enemy. You shall not lack, you will not borrow, as the year go to an end. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will see us through. The Lord will see me, both of us, our family, we all shout and praise God in 2016. In the mighty name of Jesus, we shall not die but live and see the glory of God. I pray for you, you children of the Lord, that how dear worship me, whatever you lay your hand must prosper. I pray for you, that man, that every sickness, I destroy them in Jesus' name. You, that woman, that we watch later, anything you are through, I call the name of the Lord right now to come and walk with you and deliver you and save you. You are in Jesus' name. You that barren, I say, take your children in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. We give you glory. Today is another day. We bless your holy name for what your word that has come to us today. Father, I pray right now, give your children the heart to know you, to come in their life, to come back to you. Those ones that have gone astray, Father, Lord, every spirit of flesh in your life, in my life, I destroy today in Jesus' name. May our heart turn to the Lord, our Lord Jesus Christ, in Jesus' name. And I pray for this FM radio. May they continue to prosper in Jesus' name. May the Lord be with them as we come here every Tuesday. May the God continue to shower his blessing upon this radio station, FM, My Sweet FM, the best radio. Right now, children of the Lord, I thank you all for listening. Today is the end of another Tuesday. And don't forget to join me next Tuesday at 6:30 to 7:30. God bless you. And I use this opportunity to say thank you to everyone that have been watching and contributing to the towards of this to the word of God that come to us every Tuesday. And you, if you still want to bless the work of God, or you need a prayer after the preaching, you can still call my personal number 07482664060. 07482664060. You can call me for a special prayer after the preaching, or you want to help the work of God to contribute. Father be with you. May God bless you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't forget to watch later at YouTube anytime, any day. Don't forget to tell your friends, family to go and watch later. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Thank you. Remain blessed.
By Deaconess Juliet Amos at MySweetFM.com every Tuesday from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. To listen live in the U.S., call 605-475-5848. In the U.K., call 0330-332-6335 or at 97.5 FM that you can download on iTunes. Search for My Sweet FM. To speak to me live, call 020-351-97611 and 07-555-988-739. To text me, it's 6077. You love Jesus, you love God. Ladies and gentlemen, you're invited to listen to DJ Murphy on MySweetFM.com. It's the UK's best new radio station, playing great music from all around the globe. Download their amazing TuneIn app and take this show and station with you. Broadcasting live 24/7, 365. Call into the show, tell us what you think. Artists, send in your music tracks and we will play them on the station. That's MySweetFM.com, the internet show with style. Listen live from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Saturday. It's a great show, great music, and great fun. That's MySweetFM.com.